As some of you may remember, I was on a tiny trip last week, and while I was gone, I came across a designer outlet that, among many other things, had a Versace and a Prada store. Spoiler, I did not find anything at either one of those boutiques. But while I was there, I noticed that they also had a Gucci discount store, which usually wouldn't get me too excited. I hadn't been to a Gucci discount store in a couple of years, but since I was already there, I thought I might as well stop by, and I am so glad I did, because it was 1,000 times better than I would have ever expected. So today I'll be sharing with you my experience, a little shopping vlog, and also a huge Gucci unboxing. Because if there was ever a time for you to visit your local Gucci discount store, it is now. Because you'll find pieces in stock that would have never made it into the outlet in years prior. And if you want to hear why that is, then please be sure to give this video a thumbs up and keep on watching. So the discount store that I will be raving about was at the Roermond Designer Outlet, I believe it's called. But Gucci has these discount stores or outlets, depends on what you want to call them. They are one and the same thing, potato, potato. They have them all over the world, and they actually have a dedicated page on their website that should help you locate the closest discount store to you. So you never have to worry about the pieces that you pick up from any one of these locations being authentic, because you're buying them directly from Gucci. Except you're not buying them from one of their stores, but you're buying them from one of their best kept secret locations, from one of their outlets. Because Gucci has become one of those brands that no longer put their pieces on sale publicly in their stores or even in department stores. Instead, they collect the pieces that didn't sell throughout the year, and they distribute them to one of these discount stores. So it's quite an interesting experience to go to one of them. I had been to one a couple of years ago in Woodbury in New York, which was a completely different experience than the one that I had last week. I could not find one piece in Woodbury that I liked or would have even considered. Even though I think my experience being so good at Roermond and it being quite disappointing in Woodbury has anything to do with the locations themselves, I think it came down to the timing of when I was lucky enough to be at Roermond. Because I find that usually when you go to one of these designer outlets, you'll find pieces from a few different categories. You'll often come across designer pieces that are just too essential and basic for anyone to justify paying designer prices for. You of course have the odd things that are just kind of flat out ugly, that you just don't know who designed and how they were approved and made into production, because no one would touch them with a 10-foot pole, let alone pay hundreds of dollars for them. I'm sorry to say it, but there are just some of those ugly little ducklings that designer brands come out with. But then you also find pieces from the complete opposite end of the spectrum, the runway pieces that were originally tens of thousands of dollars. Yes, they're extravagant and over the top, but if you have occasions to wear them too, or if you have a way of incorporating them into your everyday outfits, by all means go for them, because you can truly find them at a steal when it comes to designer outlets. But what are the pieces that you'll regularly find at, for example, a Gucci discount store? Well, what I was told last week is that you'll find pieces anywhere between 30 to around 70% off at a Gucci discount store, but pieces have to be at least 30% off to qualify for being sold at an outlet. So if there's something that you've had on your radar, or if there's something that you like and you're hoping to find something comparable at the Gucci outlet, you can be assured that you'll be paying at least 30% less than how much you would at an actual Gucci store, which obviously had a lot to do with why I had such a great time. Most of the pieces that I picked up were around 30 to 40% off. But that wasn't all of it, because they had the same pricing strategy in Woodbury too a couple of years ago. my experience being so great had a lot more to do with the selection and the variety of the pieces. Because last week, I'm not kidding you, Gucci had everything that you could possibly think of available in their outlet. They had everything from their more essential basic pieces through the over-the-top, shouty, fully branded lines that, let's be honest, Gucci is most well known for these days, all the way to the classic runway pieces that I personally appreciate Gucci for. So for example, they had a ton of tailoring pieces for men, denim and leather creations, as well as some stunning runway pieces for women, like full-on leather suits, sequin gowns, and hand-done embroidered beaded pieces. I mean, they had just an incredible selection in every single price range in every single category. But I have to say that the most focal point of the store was their shoe department. That was definitely the busiest. Thankfully, shoes were no interest to me, so I immediately headed to their ready-to-wear section, both for men and women, and I could not stop turning my head. There were so many incredible pieces to try on and see. They also had a pretty expensive selection of bags, which was pretty surprising to me. I was told that their latest drop in the outlets was the Zumi bag. So they had this classic, iconic shape of bag available in every single size, color, shape, design. They even had it in exotic skins. They had this one bag that I remember seeing from the Zumi line in matte alligator that was down from just under 19,000 euros to 7,500, 7,600, which I'm not good at math, but to me it sounds like an incredible saving. So even if you're looking for a new bag from Gucci, it's still worth going to the outlets these days. So they had a huge selection of not only ready-to-wear, bags, shoes, also belts, and they had the cutest little department for Gucci kids, which I wasn't surprised by that Gucci had cute designs available for kids, and let's be honest, for adults too, but I was just really shocked that all these pieces made it into the outlet. But let me tell you why that might be and what my suspicion is, because I was told that the outlets run just around a year behind the actual boutiques. So things that you see in the Gucci boutiques today, you can expect to find in outlets around a year from now on. Well, if we look back what was going on around a year ago from last week, or just what was going on last year, most Gucci stores were not open, and while I'm sure that they have a select group of customers who they sent pieces to who bought things remotely, most people were not really concerned about how they're going to get their latest Gucci pieces. So all of those things that were sitting in closed stores could only be kept on shelves for so long, because after a while they had to open up shelves and free up space for the upcoming season. And all of those things that were sitting in stockrooms while the stores were closed made their way into the outlets, which meant that the outlets were so much better stocked than they were in years prior. So that's why I'm saying that if you are going to go to a Gucci outlet, if you would ever consider going to one, it is the time to do it now, because of what was going on last year meant that Gucci had a lot of pieces in excess that they couldn't really get rid of any other way but to actually push them to their outlet stores, which meant that they had a much greater and, in my opinion, much better selection of pieces than they did in years before. So that is my pro tip. If you're gonna go, go now, go as soon as you can. I'm not sure how long this stock lasts, how long they're going to be doing this for. But what I can tell you is that based on my experience of going to the Gucci outlet a couple of years ago and going now, they were night and day. When I went to Woodbury, it was bare bones. Whereas when I went this time, I honestly just could not stop trying pieces on. Not to mention that the service was also outstanding. I really didn't know what to expect because I haven't been to too many designer outlets, but I really thought that the emphasis would be on the great prices, not really on the customer service. Well, I was really wrong. As soon as we got in and started pulling pieces that we would have been interested in trying, we got assigned someone who exclusively worked with us from that point on. And they were not only kind enough to help us find additional sizes in the bag, but they also had designs that never even made it onto the shelves, which just speaks to how much great stuff they must have available. And a little birdie told us that they get new pieces in every 2 weeks or around every 2 weeks, and that one shipment gets better after another. So I would definitely not sleep on the Gucci discount stores at the moment, because who knows when they're going to have such an incredible selection of pieces next. But one pro tip that I would have for you if you're going to go is to make sure that you book an appointment online, which you can do, I think, via the Gucci website, or I'm sure if you call ahead, they'll be able to tell you where to do it. Because we initially tried to get into the store around 7 p.m. and I think they close at 9, and we waited in line for about 20 minutes, and once we got to the door, the usher told us that they won't be able to let us in because they are fully booked with appointments for the next 2 weeks, but that we could try to go 30 to 45 minutes before they close, because a lot of the times people just make appointments online and then don't show up. But they obviously have to hold them for a little bit because of the current restrictions. They can only have so many people inside the store, which makes perfect sense. So we ended up going back, I think they closed at 9 and we went back around 8:15, and they were able to let us in, thankfully. And the store really wasn't even that busy, but it was just such a great experience that if you love Gucci, you cannot miss on checking out their discount stores. I'm thinking about cutting this video into two parts and ending part one here, because I have been sitting here for an hour and a half talking and I have not unboxed one thing, but we have a lot to go through. I have three of these gigantic Gucci bags full of stuff, and I don't want to rush through them. I want to be able to show you all the details, tell you all about them, show you mug shots and how I would style them. So I'm thinking about, yeah, cutting this video into two parts and then coming back with the unboxing on Sunday. So if you want to see that, make sure you subscribe down below. And perhaps I'll add in some more shopping footage at the end of this video, just so you get a true idea of what I saw at the Gucci store. But yeah, I think I'll do the unboxing on Sunday, and that is definitely not something that you want to miss because I'm super excited for a lot of these pieces. But for now, this is it. I really hope you enjoyed this video and my thoughts on the Gucci discount store and you found it helpful. If you did, please be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe down below. And let me know if you've ever been to a Gucci discount store. If you have, what was your experience? If you have not, would you consider going after everything I just told you? Let's have a chat about that down below. And as always, thank you so much for watching. I appreciate you being here, and I hope to see you back here on Sunday with an amazing unboxing. But for now, bye.